Hi everyone, my name is Salvatore Pottaro. I'm a PhD student at Scuola Normale Superiore, and in this video I will discuss if and how we can close the window on weakly interacting massive particles, WIMP, dark matter, with future experiments. So, first of all, we have to define which kind of WIMP we have in mind. In this project, we considered only odd electroweak multiplets with zero hypercharge, both scalars and fermions. The reason is threefold. Indeed, these models are rather minimal since they depend only on two parameters, n, that is the dimension of the multiplet, and its mass, m. Besides, in these models, the coupling of the dark matter candidate, that is the neutral component of the multiplet, to the Z boson is automatically zero, without any additional model building that would be required, for example, for even multiplets. Therefore, present-day direct detection constants can be easily evaded. Finally, these models are characterized by a rather stable IR physics, since model-dependent effects coming from higher-dimensional operators, vortex in the scalar potentials, so on and so forth, can be neglected when considering the relevant phenomenology. In particular, for example, the mass splittings between the charged components of the multiplet are induced by electroweak gauge interactions only, so that they are solid predictions in these models. As we shall see later in this video, this is relevant for a certain class of collider searches. Okay, now that we have defined our WIMP, we need to know how large is the window that we want to close, so how many multiplets we have to study. In this case, partial wave unitarity applied to the annihilation cross-section of dark matter in two standard models forces the dimension of the multiplet to be smaller than 15, so that overall we need to study only 6 candidates. At this point, we shall move to the mass. So, how do we compute this second crucial parameter of these models? In order to do this, we first have to compute the present-day dark matter abundance, which is set in the so-called freeze-out paradigm, once that the dark matter annihilation Sinton standard model are driven away from equilibrium because of the expansion of the universe. Now, the evolution of the dark matter abundance is tracked by the Boltzmann equation, where the crucial quantity that we have to compute is the annihilation cross-section into standard model. It turns out that the standard perturbative three-level annihilation cross-section, while being correct, is rather inaccurate since it misses some important non-perturbative physics related to the non-relativistic dynamics of freeze-out. In particular, the first relevant effect that we have to take into account is the so-called Sommerfeld enhancement, which consists in the fact that the interaction potential felt by the pair of annihilating particles deform their wave functions close to the interaction point. Therefore, the Sommerfeld-enhanced cross-section is obtained by the perturbative one by multiplying it by the so-called Sommerfeld factor, which is proportional to the probability of finding the two particles at the interaction point. This probability, of course, is proportional to the square modulus of the wave function of the pair of particles at the origin, which is obtained by solving the corresponding Schrödinger equation. The second relevant effect is bound state formation. Indeed, in the non-relativistic regime, a pair of WIMP bind into a WIMPonium bound state, very similar to a positronium bound state made of a positron-electron pair, within which they later annihilate into standard model. Therefore, the overall cross-section is further increased by the cross-section of bound state formation, sigma IV in this case, where this correction factor takes into account the fact that, especially at the early stages of freeze-out, bound states are broken by interaction with the thermal plasma. Once we include all these non-perturbative effects in the computation of the annihilation cross-section, we can finally solve the Boltzmann equation and then extract a prediction for the thermal masses. Our results are summarized in this plot, where the red and blue dots represent the predicted thermal masses for the scalar and fermionic candidates, respectively, as a function of n. These spans are our estimates of the theoretical error done by neglecting next leading order contributions to the interaction potentials. Indeed, as we get closer to the unitarity limit, our dynamics becomes more and more strongly interacting, so that NLO effects become increasingly important as well, and as a consequence, the error band grows. As you can see, including the aforementioned non-perturbative effects leads to an increase of one order of magnitude of or more of the predicted thermal masses. In particular, for larger multiplets, bound state formation gives the dominant contribution to the annihilation cross-section, as can be seen in this plot, where we show, as a function of the dimensionality of the multiplet and temperature, the ratio between the contribution from bound state formation and the total annihilation cross-section. Besides, the most relevant bound states, as one can expect, are those sitting in the lowest lying levels, as can be seen in this pie chart for the specific case of the fermionic 7-plet, where colors distinguish between energy levels and angular momenta, while the hue denotes the isospin of the bound state. Now that we have computed the masses, we can finally assess the detection or exclusion possibilities in future experiments. Let's start with collider searches. In our project, we considered a muon collider since it is the best environment for electrowave physics as WIMP physics. In particular, we focus on two kinds of searches. Mono or DX searches, where a pair of components of the dark matter multiplet is produced, undetected, together with one or two standard model states, which are eventually measured. The signal is characterized by a certain amount of missing energy, peaked at twice the dark matter mass, with the standard model states mainly found in the central region of the detector. And then we have disappearing tracks, where the track of a charged component of the multiplet is reconstructed until it decays to the dark matter candidate and a soft pion, both missed. In this case, the length of the charged track is in one-to-one correspondence with the lifetime of the charged component itself, whose computation can be safely done for rare candidates, as we said at the beginning of this video. Now, in this plot, we can see the collider reaches for the different channels in the case of a fermionic triplet at a 14 TeV collider. Both searches lead to a 2 sigma discovery, even if disappearing tracks are way more powerful and allow to detect triplets with much less energetic colliders. The case of the quintuplet instead is already less promising, since we first need a 30 TeV collider, and then both searches only scrape the thermal target window. This last problem can be solved increasing the luminosity. Finally, larger multiplets cannot be produced at any plausible realistic collider, since the 7-plet would require at least 100 TeV center of mass energy. So, what about larger multiplets? In this case, the main possibilities are offered by indirect and direct detection experiments. In this plot, we show the spectrum of monochromatic photons produced from the 7-plet dark matter annihilation in the halo of dwarf galaxies as a function of the dark matter mass. This is compared to the exclusion prospects of the future Cherenkov-based telescope CTA from the observation of the dwarf galaxies Draco and Triangulum. In the fermionic case, CTA is expected to detect or exclude the dark matter within the entire theoretical uncertainty on the thermal mass with both galaxies. Most unfortunately, the scalar almost exactly fits in a minimum of the spectrum, so that, especially in this case, more accurate calculations of both the mass and the spectrum, that is, including NLO contributions, are required. Finally, future direct detection experiments could, in principle, exclude the entire set of multiplets, as we can see from this plot. However, the required exclusion reach can be achieved only by a large exposure experiment like Darwin. In conclusion, we have computed for the first time the thermal masses for all scalar and fermionic real WIMP candidates below the unitarity limit, and studied the exclusion or detection possibilities in future experiments. While collider searches offer good detection chances for triplets and quintuplets, larger, heavier multiplets can be probed only by indirect detection experiments like the CTA telescope or by very large exposure direct detection experiments like Darwin. Thanks for the attention.